स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर जगदीश कुमार, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एग्रोनॉमी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी, सीएसई यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड टेक्नोलॉजी कानपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन ऑन टिलेज, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टिलेज, टाइप्स ऑफ टिलेज एंड मॉडर्न कंसेप्ट ऑफ टिलेज। नाउ कम टू द टिलेज। द वर्ड टिलियन एंड टियोलियन, meaning to plow and prepare soil for seed to sow, to cultivate and to raise crops. Jethro Tull, who was the father of the tillage, suggested that thoroughly plowing is necessary to make the soil into fine particles to grow the seed. Tillage is the mechanical manipulation of the soil with tools and implements for obtaining conditions ideal for seed germination and subsequent crop growth. Tilth is the physical conditions of the soil obtained from tillage. The tilth may be coarse tilth, fine tilth or moderate tilth. Now come to the objectives of tillage. The main objectives of tillage are: number first, to prepare a good seed bed which help the germination of seeds. Second, to create conditions in the soil suited for better growth of crop. Third, to mix up the manure and fertilizer uniformity in the soil to control the weeds effectively. Fifth, to make the soil capable for absorbing more rainwater. Sixth, to aerate the soil. Seventh, to provide adequate seed soil connect to permit water flow to seed and seedling roots. Eighth, to make the soil capable for absorbing more rainwater. Ninth, to provide adequate seed soil contact to permit water flow to seed and seedling roots. First one is preparatory tillage. Second one is after cultivation. To come to the preparatory tillage, this tillage has three groups: primary tillage, the tillage operation that is carried out after the harvest of crop to bring the land under condition is known as primary tillage or plowing. Plowing is the opening of compact soil with the help of different plows: country plows, moldboard plows, both plows, tractors and power tillers. Drum implements are used for. Come to the secondary tillage. The tillage operations that are carried out after primary tillage to bring a good soil tilth are known as a secondary tillage. Secondary tillage consists of lighter or finer operation which is done to clean the soil, break the clods and incorporate the manures and fertilizers. Harrowing and planking is done to serve those purpose. Planking is done to crush the hard clod, level the soil surface and to compact the soil lightly. Harrow, cultivators and spade are used for secondary tillage. The layout of seed bed, this is also one of the components of primary tillage: leveling, board, buck, scraper, etc. are used for leveling, or marker are used for layout of the seed bed. Second one is after cultivation, after tillage. The tillage operations that are carried out in the standing crops after the sowing, planting and prior to the harvesting of the crop, plants are called after tillage. This is also called as intercultivation or post seeding planting cultivation. It includes harrowing, hoeing, weeding, earthing up, drilling, side dressing of fertilizer, etc. Spade, hoe, beaders, etc. are used for this purpose. Now come to the modern concept of tillage. Conventional tillage involve primary tillage to break open and turn the soil, followed by secondary tillage to obtain seed bed for sowing or planting. The introductions of herbicides, intensive farming systems, the concept of tillage has been changed. Continuous use of heavy plows create hard pain in the subsoil, results in poor infiltrations. It is more susceptible to runoff and erosion. It is capital intensive and increase soil degradation. To avoid these
effect, modern concept, tillage is in rule. Now we come to the minimum tillage. It aims reducing tillage operation to the minimum necessity for ensuring a good seed bed. Tillage can be reduced in two ways. First one is by omitting operation which do not give much benefit when compared to the cost. Second one, by combining agriculture operation like seeding and fertilizer application. The advantages of minimum tillage. First, the cost and time of field preparation is reduced by reducing the number of field operation. Second one, soil compactation is comparatively less. Third is, soil structure is not destroyed. Fourth is, water loss through runoff and erosion is minimum. Water storage in the plow layer is increased. Now come to the zero tillage or no tillage. New crop is planted in the residue of the previous crop without any prior soil tillage or seed bed preparation, and it is possible when all the weeds are controlled by the use of herbicides. Zero tillage is applicable for soils with the coarse textural surface origin, good internal drainage, high biological activity of the soil fauna, favorable initial soil structures, and an adequate quantity of crop residue, as mulch tillage is mainly used in rice wheat cropping system. Advantage of the zero tillage. Zero till soils are homogeneous in structure with more number of earthworms. Second one, organic matter content increased due to less mineralizations. Surface runoff is reduced due to presence of mulch. This advantage of the zero tillage. Higher amount of nitrogen has to be applied for mineralizations of the organic matter in zero tillage. Perennial weeds may be a problem. High number of volunteer plants and build up pests. Third one is stubble mulch or stubble mulch farming. Soil is compacted at all times either by growing a crop or by leaving the crop residue on the surface during fallow period. Sweeps or blade are generally used to cut the soil up to the 12 to 15 cm depth in the first operation after harvest, and depth of cut is reduced during subsequent operations when large amount of residues are present. A disc type implement is used for the first operation to incorporate some of the residue into the soil. This hastens the decomposition but still keep enough residue on the topsoil. Disadvantage of stubble mulch farming. First one is the residual left on the surface interfere with seedbed preparations and sowing operations. Second one is the traditional tillage and sowing implements or equipments are not suitable under these conditions. Fourth one is conservation tillage. The major object to conserve soil and soil moisture. It is a system of tillage in which organic residue are not inverted into the soil such that they remain on surface as protective cover against erosion and evaporation losses of soil moisture. If stubble form the protective cover on the surface, it is usually referred to as stubble mulch tillage. The residue left on soil surface interfere with seed bed preparation and sowing operations. It is a year-round system of managing plant residue with implements that undercut residue losses of soil and the kill the weeds. Advantages of conservation tillage. Number first, energy conservation through reduced tillage operations. Second, improve the soil physical properties. Third, reduce the water runoff from field. Thank you, students.